What up, what up, what up? It's the Kickback Kid, and your boy is super pumped for that E3. Skiggity ski. Shoshibi. Yo, I'm excited for that E3 2019, man. We got a lot of games. I wanted to make a brief vid, a kind of like a slight brief vid, and I just kind of wanted to go over a couple of games that I'm most anticipated for. So I broke it down to a top three. It was really tough, but you know, I had to make a choice and I had to make a decision. So here's my top three, man. I'm gonna start with Ghost Recon Breaking Point. That game looked legit, yo. I'm not too big on shooters, you know, but looking at the trailer, it looks like maybe at least an online player campaign they got going on. I'm okay with that, you know, because I'm a big campaign guy, especially when it comes to shooters. Like, I like the campaigns. I'm not a big fan of, you know, deathmatch and battle royale and online multiplayer and shooting each other up and, you know, just developing all the skill. I mean, hey, teach his own, you know, everybody got their own style, taste, and flavor, you know, yeah. You know, but me, you know, I'm a campaign guy and I'm more of a single player guy. That's just what I do. You know what I'm saying? That's just what I like. Unless I'm playing fighting games and, you know, if I'm good enough at it, I'm gonna play online, this and that. Speaking of that, I wanted to up my skill with MK, but I mean, that's another story, okay? We talking about E3 and my top three, which I'm most anticipated, or most anticipating, the three games, that is. The three games that I'm most anticipating. And the first one is Ghost Recon Breaking Point. It looks sick. It looked dope. I like how they have the, they added like more of a, what is it, like lifestyle gameplay type element to it, where I think they were saying, I watched the trailer, and I think they were saying like you can bleed out, you need bandages, you need water for hydration, you know, all this more simulated stuff. I think that's gonna be really cool. I think it's gonna be really dope. I think it's gonna be really ski, you dig? Yee. Dope. So that's my top three, man. That's my top three for most anticipated. Like I said, this was a hard top three, because it was a lot of games. I mean, it was like Splinter Cell could have made the list, Luigi's Mansion 3 could have made the list. Even Metroid Prime 4, which I hear got delayed, unfortunately. But I mean, so many games could have made the list, but you know, and you know, y'all might be upset with this list, but hey, it's like I said, any game could have made the list. But Ghost Recon Breaking Point is my top three. It definitely looked dope. At number two, I gotta roll with Session. Okay, Session. I know that might be a little surprising. What, a skateboarding game? Yes, a skating game. I grew up, I was raised off skating games. Okay, I grew up playing the Tony Hawk games, the original OG Tony Hawk games, before skate even existed, right? And then after that, you know, Tony Hawk, I mean, I guess it just kind of just rid off into the sunset, or died, or whatever you want to call it, unfortunately, RIP. You know, I got a lot of, side note, I got like probably every Tony Hawk game. You'll see him on this channel in the future if you're into that. You know, I play the retros too. Skate, yeet. But, yeah, so I grew up off the skating games, including skate. I remember all the skates. I have all the skates. And I'm excited for Session. I know, you know, my diehard skate fans out there, they kind of like, you know, they're a little iffy about it. But honestly, I think it's going to be a lot like Skate 4. I mean, dare I say it, it might even be better than Skate 4. You guys got to understand, just because E3 isn't E3, just because EA or Black Box, I think, was the developer of the original skate games. I think it was Black Box. I think that was the name of the development company. I mean, even though, you know, there might be a new developer, you know, developing a totally different game, a totally different developing company developing a totally different game, it doesn't mean that the game ain't gonna be fire. I mean, I've seen the trailer and I know it's not gameplay, but I mean, I think the game gonna be legit, yeah, man. We gotta give it a chance, man. Like, I'm definitely gonna give it a chance. I think it's gonna be hot. So that made my top two, you know, like straight up, you know. So I'm looking forward to it. I mean, it's the closest thing to skate. I mean, I'll take it, you know. I think I'm gonna just consider it Skate 4, but that's just me. Okay, drum roll please. Here's my number one. Oh man. Okay, my number one is tick 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 bing. Alright, it's Cyberpunk. Okay. That's my most anticipated at E3. It's Cyberpunk. Cyberpunk is like basically, it's hard. It's, I don't know what you call that game. It's like a futuristic freaking Grand Theft Auto type looking game. I don't know what's going on there, but I'm really intrigued. I'm really interested, and I really want to know what's up with that game, because that game is looking legit. You know, it's looking legit. You know, and yeah, legit is my word. I'm the originator. Side note. But yeah, you know, I mean, yep. It looked hard. I mean, what else can I possibly say? You know, looking at the trailer, you know, you got the little kid dancing with the little, you know, not dancing, but, you know, I guess he was in a virtual reality game. And, you know, just watching the trailer, you see all the stuff going on. You know, I hope that, you know, the game is as good as it looks, because it looks like in that game, based off the trailer, it looks like you can do a lot of stuff. So that's really what I'm hoping for, you know. But I mean, I'm not really going to get my hopes up too high, because, you know, there's a lot of games out there that always make these amazing trailers and you get all hyped and you get all pumped. And then when you play the game isn't really like that. So let's just hope that's not the case. But I think it's going to be legit. I think it's going to be nice. I think it's going to be a cool game. Now, we're probably not going to see it anytime soon, but I'm definitely okay with that. So, yeah, you know, if you ask me personally, I would rather them release it for the next Xbox and the next PlayStation, you know, and then PC. I would rather them definitely do something like that, you know, because I just want the game to be at its best. You know, I'm a patient guy, you know, so I'm okay with that. But anyway, so that was my number one. That was my top three. I'm about to go watch some E3 now. Well, yeah, when E3 comes on, I'm looking forward to this Microsoft press conference. Hopefully they reveal the console and all that other good stuff. And yeah, after E3, I should get back with you guys. Like I said, this is just something brief, something whatever. But I should get back with you guys right after this. And well, I'll probably just talk about E3. Can't make no promises, but definitely looking forward to it. And that's what I should be doing. And it's going to be fire and amazing. So yeah, anyways, it's been a Kickback Kid. And I'm outro. All right, let's go. Deuces.